Hello everyone, Foxy here, and welcome to Mostly Mental. Today, I'd like to talk about an exciting new discovery from the world of tiling theory. Recently, as in it was announced this March, a team of mathematicians discovered something known as an aperiodic monotile. This is a huge discovery, and it's already received some great press. But these articles are all aimed at a lay audience, and they don't go into much mathematical depth. So today, I'd like to walk you through what this result actually means and show you two really cool proofs. First, let's define our terms. A tiling is a covering of the plane with a set of shapes so that every point is covered and the pieces don't overlap. So this and this are tilings, assuming they extend out forever in all directions. We're allowed to use more than one kind of shape, like these octagons and diamonds, and pieces can be rotated or reflected to fit, like these L shapes here. You might notice that both of these tilings repeat. So I can take this tiling and slide it over, and what we get will look exactly the same. And the same is true for this tiling. We call a repeating tiling like these periodic. But a tiling doesn't have to repeat. Here we have a tiling made of trapezoids. We start by arranging four trapezoids into a larger, similar trapezoid, and then we arrange four of those into an even larger one, and so on, going out forever. How do we know this doesn't repeat? Well, if we look at any given tile, we can tell by its orientation relative to all its neighbors which larger trapezoid it belongs to, and the tile's position within it. So, for example, this pink tile here is part of this trapezoid, and if we rotate that, we see that it's in position 3. And then we can repeat this process to get the tile's position within the next level of trapezoid. So this trapezoid here is part of this larger one here, and it's in position 1, which means the pink tile is in position 3, and then position 1. And we can repeat this process forever, which will give us a sequence of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, telling us where this tile is within the larger structure. That is, we can get coordinates within the hierarchy. And any two tiles will have different coordinates, since they're going to be in different places within some larger trapezoid. If the pattern repeated, then there would be two tiles somewhere with the same sequence, since that sequence is determined by the orientation relative to the neighbors. And the neighbors will all look the same since the pattern's repeating. And that can't happen since we said the coordinates are all different. So there can't be a repeated pattern. A tiling like this that never repeats is called aperiodic. These tiles we just saw allow for an aperiodic tiling, but they also have periodic tilings like so. A natural question is whether there are tiles that can only tile aperiodically. And it turns out there are. Here are a couple sets of tiles that only admit aperiodic tilings. There are already lots of great videos about both of these. I'll link something below. So I won't go into the proofs here. But these both use more than one tile. Is it possible to find a single tile, also called a monotile or Einstein, that only has aperiodic tilings? A few years back, this thing was discovered. All of these disconnected bits are part of the single tile. But that's kind of unsatisfying. I mean, it's really cool, but if you saw a tiling with these in the wild, you would think it used three different kinds of tiles, not just one. So what we really want is a connected aperiodic monotile. Meet the hat. The construction is remarkably simple. Start with a triangular grid, then connect the centers of the triangles to get a grid of these kite shapes, and then stick 8 of them together, like so, and you've got a hat. When we tile the plane, it looks something like this. It's a pretty pattern, and it feels like there are some hints of structure there, but it doesn't look like it repeats. So, how can we prove it? If you look closely at this tiling, you might notice a few common building blocks that seem to show up a lot. We've got these clusters of 4 hats, where the middle one is mirrored. We've got these 3-armed propeller structures. And if we color all those in, what we're left with are pairs of hats, always in the same configuration, and single isolated hats surrounded by the clusters. That is, we have these 4 shapes. We'll call these our meta-tiles. And it turns out, this is all we need. It's possible to show that every tiling with hats can be broken down into small regions that fit together nicely, and with the help of a computer search, we can show that every possible region can be tiled with these meta-tiles. So every tiling of the plane can be made with just these pieces. The details are linked below if you're curious about the proof. So now we have a small set of shapes, but there are still lots of bits sticking in and out at all the edges, and that's hard to reason about. So let's connect some of the corners to get simpler shapes to work with. And we can annotate these shapes like so to account for all that boundary stuff and show which pieces fit together. So now we've got 4 meta tiles, a hexagon with 2 different side lengths, a pentagon that forms 1 arm of a propeller, a parallelogram, and a triangle. Now that we have our meta tiles, how can we fit them together? With another exhaustive search, this one short enough to be human verifiable, we find there are only a handful of configurations which will work. Again, we get 4 groupings, our meta-metatiles. And once again, we have bits sticking in and out, so let's simplify the boundaries like so. Okay, I'll grant some of these are not where I would think to put the points, particularly for this one, but we want shapes that look like our meta-tiles and fit together in the same way. And if we annotate these shapes with which edges can be put together, we get this, which looks just about the same as what we got for our meta-tiles. Well, not quite the same. The side lengths are in slightly different ratios, but they're close enough for our purposes, since they'll let us repeat the process. So in any tiling we can construct, every tile fits into a meta-tile, which in turn fits it into a meta-meta-tile, which fits into a meta-meta-meta-tile, and so on. And as with our trapezoid tiling from earlier, that lets us create coordinates for each tile. Since each tile has different coordinates, the pattern can't repeat. It's aperiodic. And since this is true for every possible tiling, we only have aperiodic tilings, which means our hat is an aperiodic monotile. Now, the hat is a really cool shape, and it ties up a loose end that's been bugging mathematicians for decades, but the proof itself really isn't breaking any new ground. The argument has the same structure as most other proofs of aperiodicity. Find metatiles, put them in a recursive hierarchy, and extract coordinates. So, if that were all, this paper wouldn't have gotten mathematicians quite so excited. But the authors didn't stop there. They actually found a second proof, this one very different from any that came before. And in the process, they found not just one, but an infinite family of aperiodic monotiles. If we look at our hat as a 13-sided polygon, we see that it has sides of 3 distinct lengths, 1, 2, and the square root of 3. And if we treat that side of length 2 as 2 sides of length 1, then really there are only 2 lengths we need to worry about, 1 and root 3. And if we vary those lengths, or more importantly, the ratio between them, and keep the angles between neighboring sides the same, then we can get a whole family of shapes. So, for example, if we shrink these green sides down to the same length as the brown ones, we end up with this shape here. And then if we stretch the brown sides out to length root 3, we get this shape instead. At the extreme ends, if we shrink the brown sides down to 0, we get this chevron shape. And if we shrink the green sides to 0, we get this comet. So the hat lies somewhere on a continuum between the chevron and the comet. I'll link an animated version of this below so you can see this transformation in action. We'll prove that every shape on this continuum, except for the endpoints, is also an aperiodic monotile. Suppose we have a tiling with one of these tiles, let's say the hat. Then we can get a corresponding tiling with chevrons and another with comets by shrinking the appropriate sides to 0. To keep the density of tiles constant, we'll need to keep their areas constant, which means we need to scale the sides appropriately. And the sides of the chevrons will come out to root 2 times the sides of the comets. Since the sides of each chevron are all the same length, and the angles between them are all multiples of 60 degrees, that means the chevrons fit into a triangular grid with side lengths root 2. And similarly, the comets will fit into a triangular grid with side length 1. If our tiling with the hat was periodic, then both the tiling with chevrons and the tiling with comets would also need to be periodic. And because the density of tiles is the same, we must have the same distance between repeated parts. And since both of these tilings are on grids, that distance must be between two corresponding corners, that is, lattice points, on this grid, and also between two lattice points on this grid. But the distances between lattice points are different in the two grids. There is no distance that's the same in both. And so there's no distance where the tilings can repeat, which means there's no simultaneous periodic tiling for the chevrons and the comets. And thus, there's no periodic tiling for the hat or any other tile on this continuum, which means we have a whole family of aperiodic monotiles. And more importantly, a new way to prove things about tilings. I've had to skip over a lot of details and interesting side notes here, so if you'd like to know more, I've linked the original paper down in the description. It's well worth the read if you have the time. So, now we've proven that the hat is an aperiodic monotile. That's a really big result. But it's not the end of the story. As always, answering one question raises many more. For instance, is there a monotile with less than 13 sides? If there is one, we know it would need to have at least 5 sides, but beyond that, we have no idea what it might look like. Or if someone handed you a tile like this hat, is there an easy way to determine if it has a periodic tiling? There might not be. There are a bunch of similar problems that are known to be undecidable. But again, we don't know, and it would be really cool if there was a nice way to find out. Or what if we don't care about covering the whole plane, only a part of it? There are tiles that can't go out forever, but can at least make a few layers before getting stuck. How far out can they go? That is, what Heesch numbers are possible? The world of tilings is wide open for exploration. And who knows, maybe you will make the next big discovery. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon.